Alright, so if you see my other videos, you know what this gun is. This is a Russian Mosin Nagant. I bought this about 4 months ago. I did a video on it, a little review. So I'm doing another one again. Mainly for the update that I said I'd be getting out. I just recently put a tri-rail mount on this. It was about $22, cheaper than dirt.com. It ships to you in like 3 days. Shipping and handling is kind of on the expensive side for this, but you get a cool little bumper sticker and stuff. But you know, so the scope that I have on top here is a military grade. You can sight into about 800 yards with it. You could probably go further too, and I wouldn't be surprised. It's got a two different sight glowing the lights. It's got a red and a neon green sight illuminator. It has the elevation and windage knobs on the top here, so you can adjust it as you're moving in or withdrawing from a target. You know, not a whole lot to say about it, but I mean, you know, it's the main purpose of this video is for the rail, but I mean, it's a great rail system. I mean, you know, you don't have to have a gunsmith take care of it. You can just do it right down in your basement. The only tools that you actually need is a punch, some Allen wrenches, and a hammer. That's about it. There is no drilling required. I mean, it's just a simple installment for it. I would recommend it highly. If you don't want to ruin the rifle, or quote-unquote ruin, I wouldn't suggest getting it then. I prefer iron sights. I like iron sights, but when it comes down to wanting to shoot something accurately, you know, you kind of have no choice but to go with a scope and stuff. I mean, this is the only hunting rifle that I have right now, so, I mean, I kind of have no other choice, so, this one, I had to make it a forward-mounted scope, which means it's basically in front of the bolt. I had to do that because, as you know, if you have a Mosin Nagant, the bolt is straight up and down. So you cannot put this in front of the bolt. For snipers, when they first started doing this in World War II with their scopes, they actually had them side-mounted because of the bolt. I mean, they don't make any side mounts anymore for them, so I don't know where to get one. If you do, let me know. I'd rather put that on here, because I don't want to have to buy the aftermarket bent down bolt for it. That just kind of ruins the character of the gun. I had to make it forward mounted. The only disadvantage with that is that I have to look up just a little bit further, and I mean, that's kind of uncomfortable for a rifle like this when it should be right about here. I gotta kind of go up like this, so. That's the only disappointing part about it. I mean, I tried fiddling with this piece right here. I don't know too much about the scope yet. I don't know enough about scopes, so don't judge me when I don't know the parts of it. I don't prefer scopes, but, I tried fiddling with this thing back here. It has a positive on the left and a negative on the right. I'm assuming that has something to do with it, but it didn't make the picture any bigger from holding it back here, so that's the only thing that I gotta worry about. Back to the rail. You know, it's three sides. I think I said that already. 17 on the top, 10 on the sides. It comes with four scales for the sides to protect the ones that you're not using. You can put if you go with the smallest things you could put on here, you could probably put maybe five different things on here, at a time, depending on the combination that you use. I mean, like, I originally had, this little redhead, I think that's a 40 millimeter, red dot sight, I had on top of here at first. Battery ran dry. I'm working on getting another one. Once I do that, then I'm going to try to plan on putting it back on there again. But as far as that right now, I got to use the big scope. So, you put that on there. For the sides, you can put laser pointers, flashlights, target illuminators, whatever you want. I mean, it just, you can think of it, it'll go on there. So, that's about it for this. If you have any more questions about anything that you want to put on here, or if you want to figure out some more information about the stuff that I have on it, which is basically just the scope and the tri-rail mount, I'd be more than happy to answer some questions through email. That's about it for this. I hope you enjoyed the video. It's my chapter 2 of the Mosin Nagant. I need suggestions for videos, so if you want to know about something that you do not know, I'd be more than happy to post a video about it. I am a very knowledgeable kid of guns. I love guns. They are my passion. If only I could continue that in the future with, schooling and stuff, that'd be great. So I'm working towards something like that. Don't underestimate my knowledge. Some people think that just because I'm a teenager, I can't know anything. I actually have several books that I study through. This one is, I think, what is it called? 2011 Standard Catalog of Firearms, 21st edition. This basically has every firearm known to man. It tells them the cartridge that it uses, it tells you a little bit of the history behind it, and even has special edition guns. I have a few books, not as thick as this, but I do study that. So, if you want to know something about a gun that I've heard of, or that I've read about, you do let me know, and I'll try to get back to you on that. I got another gun that I'm going to do a video about, so I'm just going to cut out here. So, I hope you enjoyed the video, this sexy rifle here. Do leave some comments and check out my my channel, and I will be more than happy to answer any questions. Thank you.